Hello everybody, welcome to Yuka Gaming Network. I'm Zoidberg, and today I'm going to be playing some brand new Mario on the Nintendo Switch. Released on Friday was Super Mario Bros. 3D World plus Bowser's Fury, which, as the title suggests, does actually have a brand new Mario game in it called Bowser's Fury. So I thought I'd give it a play on this week's stream. So as ever, feel free to pop up in the chat and tell me how I'm doing. Comment on what you, and whether you like or like what you see, and we'll get on with it. Why is there nothing? What's going on? Why has my stream decided to die? If you have any, if there's any technical problems, then please feel free to let me know. That's Big Bowser. Teru in the chat. Yes, it is a rough start for Mario, as always. No kidnap princesses in this one. So I suppose that's a, makes it slightly different already. Okay, now this game has been hailed as the first properly open world Mario game. So let's see how that, if that actually affects things. If that fits or if it ruins the gameplay. Looking at the giant Bowser makes me think that they nicked the design concept from the latest Pokemon game. It's possible, I suppose. Mario doesn't look impressed. Well, of course you can't change him back yourself. Not when you've got Mario there to do it for you. Of course Mario's going to help. He can't help himself when it comes to an epic adventure. Cat Mario! Mario does have a hero complex, that is quite right. You have to admit, he does look rather fetching in his cat costume. You're being followed around by some little cute cats. Those are the secret collectibles. I think even more so than Mario 3D World itself, this is going to be a game for cat fans, for people who love cats. Although cat Goombas, I'm perfectly fine jumping on. Giga Bell. When the beast rises, the Giga Bell will ring. Yeah. Oh, Bowser's woken up. And Bowser's gone back to sleep again. You have to love how nice the art style of Nintendo Mario games is. Dave is now in the chat. Good evening, Dave. Hope you're well. There's a cat shine. Wonder if it. Let's head that way, shall we? I need to be Cat Mario. I'll have to work out how to change my costumes in a minute. Cat Mario. Right, let's go and hit that thing. Yay, that's it, that's how you do it. Surprised it lets you swim as Cat Mario, because we all know how much cats love water. Not tried Bowser's Fury yet, still working through 3D World. I think there's a lot of people like that. Want to replay 3D World again before they start on this one. Supposed to be knocking them all into the holes and guessing that's the idea. Good evening, Pad. Welcome to the chat. Hope you're well. No, that's just one of the reasons why I'm only playing Bowser's Fury. Five shine, so I can go and open that big that Giga Bell, can't I? That's it. Jarhead. The main reason I'm playing Bowser's Fury is because this is the new game. Whereas 3D World is a game that came out 5 years ago. I would expect nothing else from Pad, to be honest. No matter how well or otherwise I did on a Mario game I was streaming. Yeah, that's not good. try that again. The thing about collecting green stars in Mario 3D World is that that's the way you play Mario games, isn't it? Collect everything before moving on. It's true of every Mario game. Jump up me again, are you, Bowser?
Yes, you are.
Are we talking rule of three on the boss fight? I think we are. Three hits, that's the usual. Okay. Yeah, I've already done that by accident, bringing up that, so yeah. Let's go and say hello to this cute thing. Pick up that cat thing, there we go. Controlling that didn't look easy. I'm assuming you mean the dinosaur looking thingy. I think the main problem was the not being able to turn the camera fast enough. I need 15 to open that bell. See what this thing is in the lake. Not going to be a stunt course. Well, this is going to test the controls, really, then, isn't it? Just got there. Oh, that's back to the island though, where I first started, isn't it? Looks like something I can ground pound on over there. You can jump on the sea dino thing. I was pressing jump. Okay, that's back the way I came. Same course thing. Yep, there he is. Photo mode. I think which button did I press to bring up the... There we go. Ooh, what's that? I think I need to go make my way along the ice skating again, don't I? Because it looks like there is a there's a lighthouse at the end of this. Right, see where this tube leads. Send me back to the start again. Oh, it does, yeah. Uh-oh, Bowser again. Not sure I like the idea of him interrupting levels when I'm halfway through playing it. So we can get Bowser to destroy that for me. I think you'll find that I'm not the one that called him a sea dino thing. But... it's like that was Kirsty in the chat calling him that, but then Kirsty's never been a Mario fan. Always being more of a Spyro girl. Oh. And Teru has just said that it is a sea dino, he thinks. Get up on there then, don't I? Clash with Cat Boom. No, can't get up there. How do you get in this building then? Ah, maybe I need to, I'm just going to go across there for now. According to Dave the Jedi in the chat, Sparrow was just a prototype to make Spider-Man. Just because they're both made by Insomniac Games, I don't think that's quite true. The explanation is the Insomniac Games connection. Thinking of the PlayStation 1 Spider-Man games made by Neversoft that were actually used as a prototype for Tony Hawk. This is a little bit confusing. Oh! That's the last thing I needed. Although, the rain has made it so that bits are more visible. It's good. How many shines am I up to now? Ten. So I need five more. Yeah, that one there. Am I needing to go? Alright, okay. I'm needing to go over there, aren't I? Alright, come on, Plessy. Let's go. Ah, had to get it by jumping, couldn't just sit there. Right, yes. I think there's a cat behind me at the door wanting in. It's been very loud. I think they'll celebrate the Zelda anniversary just like they've done with Mario. This is Nintendo we're talking about. Of course they will. They celebrated Luigi's birthday a couple of years ago. There's no way they'll let Zelda's birthday pass unnoticed. Ha! pretty sure that Super Luigi U was part of Luigi's birthday. For New Super Mario Brothers U. No, damn it. Nintendo's Year of Luigi was celebrated in the year 2013, and it was the 30th anniversary of the first appearance of Luigi. Yeah, there was Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon Loop, that was the second one, wasn't it? And Super Luigi U for the Wii U. I've forgotten about the Mario and Luigi game on the DS because I was never really a fan of those. No, we can't count Luigi's Mansion 3. That wasn't part of the celebration. The celebration was in 2013. Right, where am I supposed to go from here? Am I supposed to jump over there and then... No, that's not right. Like that. Which one does the bot? Not the Tanuki, no. What's in there? Getting to the top of that wasn't easy. Yes, I do know about snapshot mode. I accidentally pressed the button for it before. So up to 12 cat shines now. Bowser's come out again. I don't want to go getting down from here until I've found everything that there is, because I don't want to have to climb all the way back up here again. There was a chameleon over here, wasn't there? I just saw it. going to be a shine for that stunt course down there, isn't it? And that's, I suppose that's where I need to go next. Okay. So let's go back down there then. That's a long fall. Another course for me to try and get along. I'm getting the hang of the movement on that thing now. I'm down there. There's a couple of secret cat shines over there. Let's go back to those in a bit. Blue coin bustles, that's the one. Okay, that's the one collecting all the blue coins. Bowser to have a look at. Right, so we need Bowser to destroy that thing. Still no idea how to get in there. There we go, that's swim in there, there we go. I think you're helping there, Bowser Jr. I like the fact that you can change to any ability you want at any point. That's neat. That's good. That's a nice touch. Go and use that cat. Investigate that bunny in a minute, but let's see if I can fling myself this way. Why is it not flinging me? Bowser's coming. Where's Plessy gone? There he is. Where's this giant bunny going? No. There's 15 cat shines. That means I can unlock the bell. We'll go and try the blue coin thing again while I'm waiting for Bowser to attack again. Missed one. Ah. Oh no, I lost all my coins. There is no such thing as lives on this Mario game anymore. That's one of the things that Nintendo have changed. No, I need the ice skate. I definitely need to go back up to the top and try again. Bowser's coming. Let's get to the bell. Come back to this. It's Giant Cat Mario again. Or it should be. That's what they suggested, wasn't it? Put platforms between me and him. Where's he gone? Just going to take more than three hits this time. Still got quite a big energy bar. Oh no, it's done three. That's good. Some new levels to do now. Ah, oh. Yeah, just forcing me to go back. Where's Plasti then? Let's take. Go back to the first island and have a look around, shall we? And walk through the cat gates again. Well, I can get it. Furry shadow by the shore. Oh, hello. Go back to the lighthouse. No, I haven't tried using an amiibo, and I don't particularly want to. We'll try that again. Where are these blue coins going to be? Wow. Oh. I think I need that power up. Get rid of these things. Oh, and that's precisely why it's just given me one. Well, no doubt. Does that mean that I've finished everything in this section now? I know, there's unlock more. Okay, let's go and see what they have to say for themselves. try and find the key to the cat shrine, wherever that's going to be. Going away again, Bowser. Okay, so where's that likely to be? That key there. These little helicopter boxes make getting around the level a lot quicker. Which is probably the idea. Bowser's coming. There he is. Ah, it's over there. I let the camera turn when I want it to. Come on, Bowser, what are you doing? Right, come on, one last hit. So there'll no doubt be another new large area of the map for me to explore. Some giant Bowser footprints on that one. Is this a Cat Mario one? It is. Okay, so I've wheeled it up, but I can't get at it. Fair enough. There's a lot of cats. Cats playing with a baseball. Thank you. get out of there. Get out of the black goo. Okay. Okay.
Yes.
Right, well, I think I'm going to call it a day for this week's stream. Perfect 10 landings. So, yeah, so that's Super Mario 3D World Bowser's Fury. I think there's a lot to like about it. It's got all the charm that you expect of a Mario game. There's a couple of frustrating bits on it, like the climbing of that tower that you can see in the distance over there on the left. But on the whole, I think it's everything that you would expect from a Mario game. Hope you've enjoyed watching me play it. Make sure you give us a like and subscribe for more live streams and videos just like this one. And don't forget that you can tune in to UK Gaming Network every night from 8 p.m. either on YouTube or Twitch. You can sign up for our Discord to find out the exact schedule on there. Pad should be back tomorrow night, with it being Monday tomorrow. Yeah, Pad should be back tomorrow night on Twitch at 8 p.m. Not sure what I'll be playing at this point, having finished Theme Hospital the other day. Woo-hey. I'm sure it will be very enjoyable. So thanks everybody for watching. Hope to see you all again soon.